goes something like this. When you were born, you cried, and the world rejoiced. So live your life in such a manner that when you die, the world cries, and you rejoice. Now, there's several variations of it. There's a variation that Ralph Waldo Emerson promoted. This quote, I think a lot of people have heard it. They've heard variations or whatever. And what they see in it, or what a lot of people promote that they see in it, is that the first part of it being that, you know, any child that's born, the world rejoices, you know, it's a happy moment, or it's a nice thing to say to a young person that, you know, that they're important, that they're valued. But what I want to focus on is the second part of the quote, and that's the part of the quote that says, live your life in such a way that when you die, the world cries, and you rejoice. Now, I think there's two meanings that you can grasp out of that, or there's two important things that you can grasp out of that. The first being, I think, the one that most people do, that it's not, it would be nice that, you know, you lived in such a way that people would miss you, right? And although that's very true, it's not what I think is really important in the quote. The most important thing that I can think in the quote is something I think a lot of people miss. And that's the part about you rejoicing when you die. The reason why I think that's important is to rejoice, you would have to have first experienced joy. So you would have to live your life with joy. And the only way I think that we can live our lives in just complete joy is if we're impacting other people's lives, if we're improving things around us. That, and the only way I think that you can, you know, you can live your life in joy is in a way that you're impacting others and you're improving your lives. And I think that naturally, even though we don't necessarily want people to be crying, right, it's impossible for people that you've impacted their lives and you've made a better place for them not to miss you when you die. And so what I'd like to wish for all of you, and what I hope that you do going forward, and this is a great time to start it if you're not already doing it, live your life in such a way that you impact other people's lives so much that it brings you joy. You know, and that's really, I guess, what I see when I'm talking about reducing your suck. I think each and every one of us can go out there and impact people's lives and make this world a better place. And I think that that will give us ultimately true joy, so that when we die, we can rejoice.